Welcome back to my channel, guys. It's your girl, Coco Styles, and on this channel, we talk about beauty, fashion, and lifestyle. But in today's video, I'm gonna give you guys a few tips on shopping discipline. But first, make sure you like this video and share it because I think us ladies need it, and some gentlemen. I also run a blog called Coco Styles NY, where I talk about fashion for tall women and some lifestyle stuff, but more so how to style certain things. So I'm just gonna jump right into it and let me know what you guys think. So number one would be, I'm looking down, guys, because as I was shopping, some things I was doing and I kind of figured that I would share with you guys. And the first one is knowing when to say no. All right, I have shopped a million times, and I'm sure a lot of you guys have also, and you've seen things that were really cute, like really, really cute, and your budget was not for it, okay? So, in those cases, you may really, really want this item, but I am a firm believer of having willpower. If it's out of your budget, just say no. Know when to say no to something. It's not saying that you can't get it at that very moment, but you may be able to get it in another week or so. So do not pay Peter, do not rob from Peter to pay Paul. Yeah, that's how my mom used to say it. So that's number one, knowing when to say no. Number two is, don't always buy trends. Now, we have a lot of influencers, we have YouTube, we have television, we have Instagram, Facebook, we have all these different outlets. And it's very easy for us to get caught up in what we are seeing every day because that's what it's for, to influence you to buy certain things. So, a rule of thumb is, if you see something you like, and it's something that is trendy, but it's something that can actually stay in your wardrobe for a really long time, then I say go for it. But if it's things that are just like logo driven and it may be out next season, don't do it. Don't do it. I'm telling you, your closet will be full of crap and you will be buying stuff over and over and over. And that's not the point of being stylish and having a great wardrobe. So that is number two, is don't buy everything that is trendy. All right, guys, let me know what you guys think about that one. Are you guys trendy shoppers or you kind of go away from the trends? I don't really like trends, but if I did see something that I did like, I would actually purchase it, and I may not wear it until later on down the line because that's just how I am. Number three would be, do not impulse buy. Oh my God. If I had known this when I was younger, I would have never bought the crap that I bought, okay? Being from New York City, they have stores everywhere. Everywhere you look, there's a store, there's a boutique, there's a vendor, there's something. And I've, you know, worked downtown in Manhattan near Wall Street. So that area, you see things, you see women dressing a certain way. You're like, oh my God, we should get it, would you get it? And you just go buy it. Or you're in the store and you're like, oh, I like this jacket. It's like $1,500. But your budget, not even your budget, you didn't plan on buying it. Or the jacket is very loud, I could say, like with a lot of colors and stuff. To me, that's like impulse buying or just buying really, really pricey items and you know that it's not really in your budget. So that's number three, don't impulse buy. I'm not saying that you can't do it, but I think a good rule of thumb is to have a great wardrobe with good quality things, and then you could occasionally impulse buy. So that's number three, do not impulse buy. Number four would be, this is like my favorite tip. Shop your closet before you go anywhere. A lot of us have a lot of things in our closets that's hidden, and it's hidden because we keep buying stuff and pushing it to the back or folding it in a drawer or something. So it's a really good idea to have a really organized closet and knowing where your stuff is at. I know I am guilty of buying the same type of top over and over and over, and that's because the way my closet used to be set up, it was just like kind of just bunched in together. So I have a really good organization situation going on now, but let me know if you guys want to see that closet again, because I did change some stuff around. So that's number four. Shop your closet before you go. So those are just a few tips that I think that people should incorporate in some shopping fashion, I guess, discipline type of thing. This way you're saving money, you're buying quality things, and you're not going broke trying to keep up with trends or trying to keep up with influencers. That's just a no-no. You're not going into debt trying to keep up with what you're seeing online. So if you like videos like this, guys, please comment below. And if you stay to the end of this video, please comment Coco, we see you. And guys, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Coco_styles_NY. And I'm going to show you guys what I have on today. I actually took off my sneakers, but I don't know if you guys can see. So I just have on like a high-waisted skirt. It has like, I don't know if you guys can see. It literally has like a split in the middle, and this is from COS. It's high-waisted and it's really nice. And I just have like a crop, not a crop, like a mock neck type shirt and a nice necklace. I had on some Makoyo sneakers and it was a very chill outfit, and I had on a black bag with like a gold strap with like, did it have studs? No, it's actually the bag. I think I recently showed it. But that's it, guys. If you guys stay to the end of this video, please, please like the video. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.